Here I'm playing Warcraft Total War. This is an unreleased version, version 1.9. The last released version were 1.6, but I believe enough changes have been made to the mod, so I don't think it's 1.7 or 1.8. I think it's 1.9. It's not 2.0 because for it to be 2.0, I believe it should have more of a completed state. I mean, for one, Sulfurion was doing some additional work that I don't have access to currently, such as he has added more scripts to the game, he has added unique ancillaries and traits that are Warcraft specific and not vanilla, unlike in this version. And of course, this version is lacking unit info pictures for most units, and also the text for most units. So it's not a 2.0, but it's a 1.9. All right, I'm going to play a battle here, Theramore versus the Horde. I already did, but the difference now is that I will speak when playing the battle, and also we will take a look at their units. Theramore will mostly have the same units as in the other battle that I recently uploaded on YouTube. They have mostly all units, but let's take a look at them. So they have the Mounted Archmagi. They are pretty much the bodyguard of Jaina Proudmoore, but we can't have heroes in custom battles anymore because we have reached a limit. There is a limit of 500 units in the game in total, and a hero unit in custom battle is taking up a slot, so we removed all the heroes, or most of the heroes at least. I believe maybe Illidan is still in custom battles because he looked bugged in the campaign, but in custom battles he looked good. So and then of course Artis, the Death Knight Artis might still be here, and Sylvanas, I'm not sure. Anyway, Jaina is not in the custom battles, and none of the Horde heroes are either, and Artas the Paladin isn't either. Anyway, Mounted Archmagi is pretty much the bodyguard of Jaina Proudmoore, but they are also their own unit. Then we have Mounted Paladins, we have Theramore Cataphracts, and we have the Human Knights. They are usually the bodyguard of most generals, but I choose the Mounted Archmagi here for Theramore. And then the Human Cavalry, of course. All of these are old units, but the Theramore Cataphracts have gotten a new skin, so they are less cartoony now, they look better. Then we have the Dwarven units in use by Theramore, the Dwarven Rifleman, the Griffin Riders, the Steam Engines from Warhammer, and Flying Machines from Warhammer, but with Warcraft Dwarves. We have the mortar teams, the siege engine is from Warhammer, but the dwarves are from Warcraft, alright. Then we have the Theramore Archmagi, their unique mage unit. They have the water elementals, another mage unit that are summoned by these guys, but they start already summoned. Same with the mud golems, they are summoned by mages, but they start already summoned, of course. And then we have the elves that join Theramore, the Elven Rangers, and here's a new unit, Silverpine Rangers. It's a former Lordaeron unique unit, but they are now also available to Theramore. So they are like the Elven Rangers, but slightly worse in stats. Then we have the Kultras Marines. They are still much better than the Archers. Anyway, we have the Kultras Marines. They are a unique unit for Lordaeron and Theramore. They were in the game previously for Theramore. Then we have the Gnome Mech Warriors. They were unique for Kasmuran, the dwarves. But after I read that some of the gnomes also joined with Theramore, I chose to add it to Theramore. They needed more good infantry units, and this is the only gnome unit in the game. We have the Theramore Golden Pikes. They were in the game previously, but now they have a new skin. They look much more badass now, and I made a new unit card for them as well that looks much better, because the old one was very cartoony, very light colored. Alright, and they have the Great Swords of Arator. They had a legion from Stromgarde, 7th legion or something, joined them, so this represents that, and then they have the Gilden and Claymores. If you take a look at their custom battle screen, you can see that they also have the Red Legion of Arator available. All these Stromgarde and Lordaeron units and Kasmodan units, not the dwarves but the gnomes, they will be available in custom battle, of course, but they will also be available in the campaign. They will only be available at start for Theramore in the campaign. It will be hard for them to recruit more. I'm not sure. Maybe they were recruitable from Theramore only, the capital. But I'm not sure about that. I might not have added that. I'm not sure. But they will have them from the start because they followed with Jaina to Kalimdor. But after that, it's very hard for Jaina to get more of them. But at least they will help Theramore in the beginning to have a chance against the Horde in the campaign. Alright, so they have also access to the Red Legion of Arator. And then if we scroll down, we can see that they also have the Red Legion Equestrian, the Elite Stromgarde Cavalry, but not the best one. They have another one too that isn't available to Theramore. Then they have the Knights of Tyr, the Lordaeron Elite unit as well. Lordaeron Elite Cavalry unit, and they will also be available at the start, but it will be hard to get after that. If Theramore conquers Lordaeron territory, they will be able to recruit these units, by the way, or Stromgarde. But as long as they don't have the Stromgarde regions or the Lordaeron regions, they will only have the starting units, I believe, of their troops, and then they won't get any more. So they need to pretty much go back and take the areas from Lordaeron or Stromgarde to get more of those units. If I'm not wrong, I might have added recruitment for them in Theramore only, but I'm not sure. Alright, so that's Theramore. They have more units from the other human factions, etc. They are stronger. Then if you look at the Horde, if you can see here, I've added like all the Amani. All the Smoldertorn, Dark Horde trolls to the Horde as well, all the Ogres, and they also have the Blackrock Destroyers. But if you look at their army, I've changed stuff because they were owned too easily in the last battle. So now they have their bodyguard, the Korkron bodyguard. Then they have the Farseers. They have a new Warcraft styled projectile, by the way. And the Farseers, these mounted Tramans, they are pretty much all Tramans. They are pretty much the Farseers, but dismounted. They have a different model, but they have the same projectile. So these two units have new projectiles, very cool looking projectiles that Bantu Chieftain made. Then they have, of course, the Kudu Riders, the Orc Wolf Riders, and the Weaven Riders, all units. They have the Darkspear Shadow Hunters, a ranged unit. They have the Bat Riders throwing bombs, an all unit. They have the Mounted Darkspear Headhunters, now with Warcraft Raptors. That's all too. I believe it was added in December 2018 in the 1.5 update. And then we have the Darkspear Headhunters throwing javelins. We have the Goblin Bombards. I know that the old version released, the 1.6 version, had the old unit card for the Goblin Bombard in use by the Horde. Now I've updated the picture, so it's the recent picture now. Otherwise it's the same unit. And Blackrock Destroyers, that's the bodyguard of the Dark Horde Orcs. Rest of the roster is pretty much reskinned Horde Orcs, so same units, but this is the only unique Dark Horde Orc unit, and they are now available for the Horde as well. If the Horde takes the areas in Eastern Kingdoms, the Dark Horde areas, they will get their units, like Ogres, the Blackrock Destroyers, and the Smoldertorn Trolls. However, they can get Ogres from one area or two areas in Kalimdor as well. There are two Ogre areas in Kalimdor. I believe it's Brackenwall and another area, and if they take two areas, they can get the Ogres too. Maybe not all of the Ogres, but at least the Ogre Bone Crushers. If they take the Dark Horde areas, they can get all of the Ogres, with the exception of the half ogre infantry. They are available in the custom battles, but they aren't in the campaign, because I think it's a very Dark Horde unique unit. It didn't fit the Horde. Alright, and then they have the Blade Masters, a new unit from 1.5, added in December 2018. And then we have the Orc Berserkers, the Orc Warriors, and the Grounds with the new model added in December 2018, 1.5. So it's not very new, but it's more recent than the old versions. Alright, we have the Orc Shamans with a new projectile, we have the Orc Necrolites with a different projectile, and we have the Ogre Bone Crushers, because I think they fit. A group of ogres joined Troll after he took Brackenwall in Kalimdor, so they should have at least one unit of Bone Crushers here. And then they have the best unit of the Tuskar. They have three Tuskar units. If they take the Tuskar area in Northrend, one area, then they can recruit these as regional troops in the campaign. But in custom battle, I thought it was enough to represent the Tuskar with one unit, their best heavy armored unit. So they have the Tuskar long tusks here. Then they have the same situation with the Tanka. The Tanka have two units. The Tanka Braves, the smaller ones, they are like the Tauren Warriors, and then the Tanka Warhorns, they are like the Bloodhoof Thunderhooves, much bigger. And I thought the Tanka Warhorns, Warhorns should be represented. If the Horde takes the Tanka areas in Northrend, I believe it's three or four, then they get these units from there. So they are now represented. Alright. I might have forgotten the actual Tauren. So I remove a unit there. We will add the Bloodhoof Thunderhoofs instead of the Javelin Throwers there. We want the Tauren Warriors as well. So the question is what we should remove. Right. I don't want to remove the trolls, they are very unique. Maybe I remove the goblins. Tanka warriors like that. Right. The humans have one siege engine. Right. Remove the ogre, and the Horde capital was catapult was in the trailer, but let's add a bomber, it's better. So the goblins are represented, and yeah, I think this will have to do. Alright, so we remove the ogre, but otherwise they have a full army of, and they have now the Tuskar long tusks, the Tanka warhorns, and they have new projectiles for the Farseers and the Orc Shamans, and they have the Blackrock Destroyers and the new Goblin Bombard. Alright, let's start the battle. Fuck, I forgot to change the battlefield. It's not the battlefield I wanted to use. I will need to exit and restart. I will end the recording here, so I don't have to record everything when I click everything again. Alright, see you soon. So I'm back. As you can see, the same armies, but a different battlefield now. We have the proper Durotar battlefield. I've changed to the Corcoran bodyguard. It's not the bodyguard. We used the Farseers to make them equal with the Theramore bodyguard, so mounted archmagi and the horde equivalent, the farseers. Alright, let's start the battle. Demigod has fallen. The war song is supreme. Grom Hellscream, warlord of the Warsong clan. Start deployment. Alright, we will order this unit to retreat immediately. And pause the game. Take a look at the armies. So we can see here the Horde cavalry. They have the skirmisher cavalry, the Weaven riders here, throwing javelins, and they can circle and fruit. When you use this unit, you should use the circle and fruit ability. They will fly around in circles fruiting. Otherwise, they will just stand still, and that's not good. Alright, and then we have the Orc warriors. They are still using the old model. I had hoped that Banty would update the old models by using the new ground model as the base. I believe we can just remove the shoulder pads here and some of the gear and change the weapons and helmets, etc. And we'd have a much better model for all their units. But currently they are using the Warcraft 3 models here, while the Grunts are using the much better model. And then we have the Tuskar long tusks here, heavily armored infantry that will aid them in this battle. We have the best troll unit here. I don't remember the name, but they throw these things. Unfortunately, we don't have a projectile like this, so they will throw like spears, I believe, or something. We have the Orc Shamans with their new projectile. We have the Orc Necrolites. They will throw the old projectile. Then we have the goblins with their bombard, the goblin bombard here. The models added in the 1.5 update. We have the farseers here with the captain here on the rider. And we have the farseers, the new projectile. And take a look at the army here. We have the Corcrum bodyguard here, heavily armored, but they are still Warcraft 3 models. Little outdated. We have the Tauren here, the Thunderhoofs. Alright, they are the biggest Tauren, and then we have the Tauren warriors here, the smaller ones. We have the Blackrock Destroyers, also using Warcraft 3 models. And we have the much better looking Blade Masters here, with a modern model. Fan-made, and then we have the Berserkers, and we have the Tonka, whatever they were called. They are the better ones, the bigger ones, equal to the slightly less powerful than the big Taurans. I believe the Tonka are slightly less powerful. We have some troops over here, more cavalry. We have the Orc Raiders on their wolves. We have the Kudo Riders throwing axes, and we have the troll javeliners on raptors here. Alright, that's the Horde. Much better army compared to in the last battle. And then we have the Theramore army. We have the Warhammer Beginning of the End Times copters here, but with Warcraft crew. Alright, they throw bombs at the enemy. And then we have the steam tank from Warhammer, but retextured, because we didn't have a Warcraft one. Anyway, that's the Dwarven steam tank was supposed to be. Then we have the Griffon riders here with Dwarven riders throwing hammers, but it's the projectile is an axe. Right, and then we have the ordinary cavalry, but I forgot to update their armor. That wasn't good, I forgot that. So they have the earliest version of the armor. They have three I'd like them to have the third variation where they are full armor, but I won't redo everything now. And here we have the knights. They have lances, unlike the cavalry, which only has spears. And then, if you look at their army, we have the new Theramore Golden Pikes. The unit is old, but the texture is new. They are not cartoony anymore. They are much better looking, much more serious looking. Not as cartoony. I like this style a lot more than the old. And then we have the Guild and Claymores here. Bantery did the texture for the Golden Pikes. And then we have added the Great Swords of Arator from Stromgarde here, representing the 7th Legion. And we have the Gnome Mech Warriors representing the Gnomes that followed with Jaina. And if you look at the cavalry over here, we have the Theramore Cataphracts, their elite cavalry. And they also have a better texture made by Banty now. They look less cartoony as well. We have the Mounted Paladins. Strong cavalry unit. We have the Mud Golem. It's just one in custom battle, but they are three in campaign. I will change that because I now know how to do it. I have to use scripts. So they won't be recruitable anymore, because that will automatically force them to be three. Alright, so the only way to have them one is have them be one is to spawn them through the script. We have the unique Theramore Archmage here, mage unit. We have the Summon Water Elementals, another mage unit, and we have the Elven Rangers with the unique skin for Theramore. Older unit. We have added the Silverpan Rangers from Lordaeron. Almost as strong as the Elven Rangers. We have the Kultras Marines, shared with Lordaeron, otherwise unique for Theramore. And we have their bodyguard of Mounted Archmage. And that's the army of Theramore and the army of the Horde. Alright, let's unpause the game and watch the battle. So they are, the Theramore army is marching, they seem to be regrouping or reforming, like they always do on this battlefield before they charge. We have the Gnome Mechs here, really cool unit, I like it, and then of course the new texture for the Golden Pikes is so much better. I just wish the old orc units could be updated. I know we could use the new grunt model as a base and just move the weapons, etc. I could do that myself, but problem is the texture. It would be troublesome to edit the textures, because Bantu made like 5 to 10 units in one texture. So would be annoying to edit the textures to make them fit with the new weapons. There are no room for new weapons, etc. That's the problem. Otherwise it would be easy to just move over the weapons to the better model. Shame I used the earliest version of the human cavalry and not the better one. The Horde is all the way over here. This battlefield, by the way, was made by Warcraft Hero. He used the textures from the campaign map made by the Holy Crusader and the creator of the map, and then he managed to move over the textures to the battlefields, so he got the Warcraft battlefields. Utter defeat, yeah, my army routed. So the Horde has started to move. My army was just a bodyguard. I believe this unit should be the base for all their units, but with different gear, of course. That would be so much better than having outdated models like this. But banned the reason that it would lag or be less likely to crash if we have the old models. But I don't think it makes that much of a difference. Anyway. Blade Masters with their banners and everything. They look good. Blackrock Destroyers, Mounted Farseers, some goblins here as well. Goblin crewmen with their bombards, vanilla bombards. Look a lot like the old Warcraft cinematics. The orc necrolites here added to make them even, because the Theramore faction had 3 ranged units, and I believe that the Horde needed a similar amount or similar number of casters. You also got a lot more elite stuff in this army compared to in the last battle, where they had much more basic stuff. Hopefully it will be more equal. So the balance of forces is evenly matched. Percentage enemies killed 5%. What? Allies killed. That was my unit, yeah. Alright, so our army is actually at a disadvantage. So Theramore is at a disadvantage according to that statistic screen. But we'll see. Casters can do a big deal of damage to the army. So Theramore might be able to change things around. They also have the Mud Golem, and it's not to be underestimated. The Horde has no real giant unit like this. They only have smaller giants like the Tauren and the Tonka. They are strong, but they are not as strong. So the army is still marching up. They are not that far away from each other now. Taurens are at the forefront there. I want to take a look at the new projectiles of the Shamans and the Farseers as well, as they are new, much more suitable for the units. The battle is about to start. Armies are currently looking at each other and moving into position in order to charge against each other. Yeah, this model should be the base of all the basic orc units, I believe. I will ask Bante about that. It would be so much better than having an old model like this for most of their basic units. This unit is so much better suited for that. Alright. Same with the Dark Horde. They could use a unique version of the better models. They had a better model too. So the Horde is sending forth their Farseers, their General's Bodyguard here. Caster unit. Doing the same move as Theramore did in the last battle, where they sent forward the Mounted Archmagi. So we will soon see them firing the new projectile. Look at that. The Mages versus the Farseers. They are firing, the Archmagi are firing fire bolts. Old projectile, while the Farseers are firing the new electric projectile inspired by the Warcraft games. Looks much better and much more correct. So the mounted mages don't have that much ammunition, so that's the weakness of the mounted Archmagi and the Farseers, that they don't have a lot of rounds to fire. However, the dismounted mages seem to have unlimited amount of ammunition, so they can fire unlimited amounts of mage projectiles. and that's maybe something I will change. So they will be nerfed by simply limiting their number of projectiles. They can't fire an endless amount of projectiles against the enemy. The other thing I will do, or have done already, to nerf the mages is that I have changed the projectiles of the priests of the Holy Light and the elven arcanists because they were too overpowered. That projectile is no longer in use, so they no longer have that OP projectile that they used to have. Instead, they have more lore-friendly projectiles. So the elven arcanists and the priests of the Holy Light have new projectiles as well. The priests of the Holy Light, they are not a unit in the Theramore roster. They are in all the other human rosters, but not the Theramore one. So that's why they aren't in this battle. The battle is raging on here. Let's zoom in on the minimap. See the projectiles flying all over. Here we have the mounted paladins. They are fighting the orc raiders. There will probably win. Well, the mud golem is fighting a lot of orc berserkers. There we have the elven rangers and silver, the Lordaeron and Silverpine rangers, firing arrows. Well, we also have some mages here, the orc shamans firing the new projectiles against the enemy. The Darkspear Shadowhunters have that projectile that they fire. Also we have the Orc Necrolites. I don't exactly know what they throw, but some dark projectile, I believe, from Warhammer. And then we have the newly reskinned Golden Pikes fighting the Corcrum Bodyguard. The AI is stupid enough to use the Weaven Riders in melee instead of using them to circle and shoot like they are supposed to. Tank here is also surrounded by Orc Grunts and Orc Warriors. We have the Tauren here, the big Tauren, fighting off the Kultras Marines who have been forced into melee. Otherwise they can fire their rifles, and are very effective because they don't have to reload their guns. They can fire multiple shots at once and fire all the ranks at once. The Theramore Archmagi are firing firebolts from behind at the Tauren. They are helping the Kultras Marines, but I believe the Kultras Marines are now so depleted that they won't ever be a threat in this battle. Some of the Stromgarde units, the Great Swords of Arator, have joined the battle there as well. We have the cavalry fighting the Tauren warriors, more specifically the Theramore cataphracts there, fighting both the Orc Berserkers, the Blackrock Destroyers, and the Tauren warriors. They are aided by some Gilnan claymores there. We have some cavalry, unfortunately not with the armor, fighting there. They just fled. No wonder they didn't even have the armor upgrade. And the Orcruns are cheering that they just won that battle. We have the Gilnan claymores here. They are winded. 54% enemies killed, 62% allies killed. Very equal battle. But it seems Theramore will lose according to the statistics. Fortunately, their water elementals have joined melee battle instead of firing from afar like they are supposed to. Still have their rangers and silverpine rangers firing from afar. Only a few of the cataphracts are remaining. Here we have some Tanka warhorns fighting the paladins there. Shame they used most of their range units in melee. No wonder they lost. Yeah, the Tauren Steerers are big, but they aren't too big. Oh, the Horde has taken out the steam tank. Gnomes have routed. Horde have lost their captain. So the battle was much more equal this time. But I believe the Horde used their mages better in this battle. We haven't seen the Orc Necrolites do anything. I wonder why they aren't firing. So 59% enemies killed, 75% allies killed, so Theramore is losing this battle. Some cataphract still fighting the Tonka there, Tonka Warhorns. Horde still has the Tuska long tusks here. They're in peaches. The Taurens are not defeated either. Seems the Theramore faction wasted their long range units in the still have some dwarves here, dwarven riflemen. They're firing. They can also fire everything at once, so they're much better than before. Previously, when they had to reload the guns, etc., they were actually worse than the archers and crossbowmen. So I had to make them like this in order to make them more effective than the archers and the crossbowmen. They are supposed to be better, they are riflemen after all. Alright, the Tauren warriors are now charging them, forcing them into melee. They are not worthless in melee, they have a mace or something, I believe. Yeah, hammer. It's not their cup of tea. Alright. So the Horde has won this battle. 63% enemies killed, 83% of our Theramore army and allies killed. Alright. So this battle became a victory for the Horde. But we got to see some more units in action and the new Horde projectiles. Theramore was at a clear disadvantage from the start in this battle. Could have given them the better cavalry of the Lordaeron, the Tears Hand of Lordaeron, and the Stromgarde equestrians, but I chose not to because I thought they would be more of an equal fight, but well, it seems they got wrecked. Became almost too easy for the Horde this time. In the last battle it was too easy for Theramore, and in this battle it was too easy for the Horde. I almost want to replay it and add some better stuff to Theramore. Better cavalry. Alright, we'll see about that. Then I need to remake the video and talk again. Alright. So we have some Corcrum bodyguards still alive there. So the Orc Necrolites are finally going to fire. So they are firing this dark projectile against the enemy.
Lord, preserve us! We have been dealt a stinging defeat today.
And the battle is over, the Horde won. Alright, clear defeat. Battle results. Men deployed. Captain Trevor 63. Lost 1. He fled. Captain Marcus had 1223 men. Captain Tamar had 1230 men. So the Horde had only a slight advantage in numbers. But Theramore lost 1135 and the Horde lost 718. Alright, men remaining only 88 of the Theramore army and 512 of the Horde army. So the Horde won big time. The Horde killed 1001, 53 while they were routing or running away. And the Theramore army killed only 816, none while they were running away. I believe we could fight the battle again and give them better cavalry and see if that will change anything. Alright, see ya.